Did you know that incorrect tire inflation pressures can cause yield-robbing compaction and performance issues such as power hop? Properly inflated tires are critical to avoiding these costly problems. The last step before going to the field is to adjust the tire pressures. After watching this video, you will be able to determine the correct inflation pressures for the axle load. Higher pressures will allow the tire to carry more load. The goal is to have just enough pressure to carry the axle load. The first thing we need to do is determine the maximum weight that is on each axle. This includes the weight of the tractor, any ballast that was added, and also any implement weight that is being carried by the drawbar or the three-point hitch. Just like the suitcase weights, there is a leverage effect that adds more weight to the nearest axle than what the implement actually weighs. This needs to be considered when determining total axle load. The best way to determine total axle load is to weigh each axle on a scale with the implement hooked up and in the condition where the maximum amount of weight is added to the axle. If a scale is not available, you will need to calculate the axle weight. For example, if using a hitch-mounted implement, weigh the rear axle with the implement raised and weigh the front axle with the implement lowered to the ground. Once you determine the axle weight, then you can use the recommended inflation tables in Section 80 of the operator's manual. Or you can go to the tire manufacturer website to find the pressure needed for your tires. Locate the correct size tire and load index at the top of the table and then find the axle load on the left side. For this example, we have a 9620R equipped with dual 870R38 tires. The front axle is carrying 31,800 pounds and the rear axle is carrying 28,200 pounds. You can see we need 10 PSI in the rear tires and 12 PSI in the front. Check tire pressure when the tires are cool using an accurate gauge having a 1 PSI increment. Inflate as necessary, and remember that all tires on the same axle must be inflated to the same pressure. This is critical to prevent power hop. Check tire pressure often to keep them inflated properly. Also, anytime you switch to a different implement or there is a large temperature change, check and readjust. Now that you have set your tire pressures, you're ready to go to the field and confirm if the initial ballast and tire pressure settings are correct, which we will discuss in part 4 of this video series.